Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Rob Brock, and in this edition we have KDBindings, Reactive Programming and Data Binding in C++, an interview with Leon Matthes, Qt 6.3 Alpha released, Tip of the Month, and announcements. As a Qt developer, you certainly know about signals, slots, and properties. Those of you who have used QML will know that property bindings are super useful and cool. Bindings allow us to write more reactive and declarative style code. However, they're only available within QML, which means there are no compile time errors when you do something wrong. Earlier this month, KDAB released KDBindings to make these useful and comfortable techniques available also in pure C++. I have the pleasure to talk to one of the developers, Leon Matthes, today. Hi, Leon. How are you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
Not bad, thank you. So how did you or the team come up with the idea for KDBindings?
So actually, the team came up with the idea, and it's basically arose from our want to have the amazing features that we're used to from Qt, because at KDAB we work a lot with Qt, like you probably know. And we wanted to have these features in projects where we can't use Qt for whatever reason, be that because it's too small and we can't pull in all the dependencies, or we just don't need an entire GUI, but we still wanted to have access to these awesome features that are properties and signals and slots that we are used to from Qt.
Yeah, they are useful features, especially if you get used to using them and then don't have access to them anymore. What would you say are the most important features or functions of KDBindings?
So in my opinion, I think the really headline features is that we actually managed to get properties and especially data binding working in pure C++, which means that you can just write very expressive code that gets reevaluated whenever necessary. Whenever any of your input data changes, basically, you then automatically redo all the calculations that are based on that input data, and it will update everything in your code base that relies on this input.
Right. A great feature then, indeed. Anything else you would like to point out or that you would recommend to our viewers?
I just generally would recommend to read through our Getting Started guide on our docs. It's really comprehensive and should cover all the features. And also one of the things that you might want to take a look at if you're already a Qt developer is our deferred evaluation feature, which is really new and it doesn't even work in Qt. But we've added this so that you can defer evaluation for things that you might otherwise calculate like twice or three times. And it also allows you to control when you want things to be evaluated. For example, if you want to control your update speed of certain variables.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much for your time, Leon.
Thank you as well.
So there are two blog posts about KDBindings that we provide in the video description. If you try it out, please give us your feedback in the comments here or under the blog posts. Middle of January, the alpha version of Qt 6.3 was released and is available for testing. This version adds new features, especially in the Qt Core module, Qt Widgets module, and Qt Quick 3D module. Also, it adds a language server module that implements the language server protocol specification and the JSON RPC 2.0 protocol, and reintroduces the Qt PDF module. Further, with version 6.3, a new Qt Quick compiler will be introduced. It will consist of two components, the QML type compiler and QML script compiler. The QML type compiler will compile QML object structures into C++ classes. The QML script compiler will compile functions and expressions in QML files of an application into C++ code. You can read more about the technical details in the blog post below. If you do try out any of the new features, let us know in the comments which ones you find the most useful. Tip of the month, the two-way binding problem and how to avoid it. In a well-designed QML application, the UI is built using reusable components, while the data and logic live in C++-based components we at KDAB call controllers. The QML part of the application uses these components, that themselves may be written in QML or C++, to build up the user interface and connect with the controllers. In this setup, the controllers provide the data as well as receive input from the UI. So how hard can it be? Well, there are a few pitfalls and solutions. There are several ways to approach this issue, and it's not completely trivial to come up with an approach that matches the criteria we set out with. Easy to use, hard to get wrong, and as light as possible. The unbreakable binding approach seems a most suitable first go-to solution. Read more about it in a blog post, linked below, written by KDAB's André Somers, and let us know your experience with these kinds of problems. As of now, early bird tickets for QtDevCon, taking place the 13th to the 15th of June 2022 in Berlin, are available. The program consists of a training day, where you can choose one out of 10 full training courses, and two conference days with interesting talks around Qt development in all facets. Check out the website, linked in the description below. For C++ developers who like to give talks at conferences, several C++ events are still calling for speakers, namely CPP Now, happening the 1st to the 6th of May 2022 in Aspen, Colorado, CPP on C, taking place from the 4th to the 7th of July in the UK, and last but not least, CPP Con, who are looking for Academy class proposals for their event in September. As usual, all links below. Finally, KDReports 2.1.0, a tool that generates printable and exportable reports from code and from XML descriptions, is now available. It comes with a new feature, the reports.mainTextDocument method. This method returns the QTextDocument for the main part of the report, so no headers, footers, or watermarks, which is useful for displaying the report in a read-only QText editor or QText browser. Take a look at the online demo link below. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and of course, feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. I'll see you next time.